You're a remarkable talent. Someone with a chance to do something very special in the league.
I'm ready.
We welcome you to Nache and Beyond here on 2K Sports. From the attire to the food, the players' jerseys, tonight, a celebration of the Latin culture. Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and we'll have David Aldridge filling a moment now to look at the year-to-year scoring output and how it has been trending for him.
And his scoring numbers have been going in the right direction these past few years. He's gotten better and better at handling what those opposing defenses are throwing his way and finding ways to get his points all over the floor.
And the starting lineup for the Timberwolves. We've got Bagley, also Bamba out there, and it's Noel in at the two guard. And for Los Angeles, Wilson out there with Cowboy, then it's the Kid, and there's the Monster, and it's Miracle Man in at the point guard.
Nice work to get it inside and draw the contact.
Exactly. The defense determined not to allow the easy layup right there. They'll settle for making him earn the free throw.
Greg, if your system overall for these teams, if the schemes don't seem to be working, how much can you really change before you get to the offseason, or in particular, before you get to the playoffs?
It's never easy. A system change would come typically with a coaching change, and the reality is you also have to evaluate the roster, and you can't fit that square peg into a round hole. Whatever your system is, it's got to be catered to the personnel you have. You can't go the other way around, and I think that's what separates oftentimes the good coaches from the great ones.
Off the inbound pass, Wilson with the block, and he gets it back.
No question he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
The Timberwolves shooting their first free throws of the game. First one falls for him.
Two shots.
Good on both.
Probably as close to a sure thing as you can have at the free throw line.
Here's Miracle Man, and down it goes, jamming that one home.
It puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, GA. He really does put pressure on you.
And you know, guys, showing how dynamic a weapon he is for this offense, they feed off of that energy and ability to make plays. It gets them going.
We have got to see that sensational mobile one block again.
Some intimidation right away. Got to show those shooters you're going to be there all night long.
His second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2 for 2.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
And Walker kicks to Bamba. 6 on the shot clock. Fires for 3. That shot is off. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Last time they met was in Minnesota, where they beat the Timberwolves.
In the last meeting of these two teams, they were really sharp defensively, disrupting the flow of their offense and causing a ton of turnover.
Very satisfying performance, and one they'll look to repeat tonight. I mean, they ended up winning it going away.
And that's another basket for them. They have really come out blazing here in the first.
The Timberwolves have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Right side to Walker. Bagley with the bucket.
Terrific awareness that time from Walker. Nice job getting his open teammates the rock.
Down low. Here's the Monster. Minnesota with the rebound. They come in fresh off a win against the Warriors.
Well, you look at the points they produced in that game. Great adjustments on the offensive end.
Well, it's really hard to stop them when they're in a groove offensively, and they were in a comfort zone all game long in that one.
For Los Angeles, they've gone 5 of 6 so far from the field to start out the game. And it's Leonard with the jam.
And he just dangles from the bucket after sending that one through.
And you can see which team has the swagger right now.
Well, you know what? You don't want to do too much to get an opponent riled up. You got to be mindful of that.
And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for Los Angeles.
And so far, these guys have done a fantastic job finding the open man and getting some easy baskets.
Something else they've been able to do so far tonight is earn those tough points in the paint.
Thunder's checked in for Miracle Man. Here's Tyler. Bagley with the rebound. And so it's Bagley with it. He brings it up for the Timberwolves. 6-point game. Bay gets the bucket.
And they don't want to get in a habit of giving him open looks from three. First quarter still, but not who you want to leave open. That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
Walker surveying the floor. Count it. Good.
Yeah, Walker seemed unbothered by the defense there. Very creative with the rock in his hand.
Leonard the pass to Tyler. It's 2-on-1. Here's Noel. And again, it's Minnesota.
Boy, he is looking confident. Love how they're using him so far.
And you know what? They're going to keep using him. I mean, he'll be the centerpiece of their offense today. You can bank on that. Boy, just not scoring with the efficiency he'd like to. Tough quarter for him.
And, folks, he did not luck into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that backboard.
So, timeout called here. The first for Los Angeles.
They're trying to stem the tide here.
Yeah, you know, they had to do something, anything, to stop this run. You can't just let it go on any longer.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles, the professor's checked in for the monster. ABC comes in for Tyler. Money's checked in for Magician. And Rain Man subbed in for Leonard. And here are the Timberwolves. They're on a 15-6 run. Here's Noel. It's deflected. It's stolen by Sharks. Shots good by Noel. Noel's got 6 points.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Greg, 11 years for you in the NBA. You had to have some favorite players that you played besides and with.
You know, it's a great call, and there were a ton of them. A few guys, though, Wilson. Gary Payton, I got a chance to play with Gary for a year and have known him. We used to go at it in high school, and it's really about his personality. This is a guy that constant chatter, practice on the court. That's what fed his confidence. Charles Oakley, another guy. He would run through a wall or through you to win a game. And then Scottie Pippen later in my career, just a winner and somebody who I competed against for many years, but then having the opportunity to play with up close, I got a greater appreciation for his skill set.
.114 left in the first quarter of the game. And the foul called on ABC. That is his first foul of the game. And so it's Minnesota with it. And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for Minnesota.
They've made the commitment to get out and run, and it's paid off with some highlight reel plays in transition.
They've gotten their fair share of points off turnovers so far tonight, too.
Here's Gary. Oh, and there's the one-handed jam.
Taking matters into his own hands.
Yeah, we didn't expect to see that kind of finish.
And you know, guys, when your point guard is making explosive plays at the rim, I really do think it sets the tone for the rest of the team.
And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing. And the foul called on Los Angeles. The Timberwolves shooting their 7th and 8th attempts at the foul line tonight.
And although he started playing the game later in life, Hachimura has picked it up well, and exciting young player to watch. Punch, counter punch, impressive offensive production early on.
Hey, guys, this is going to be fun now. I mean, we've got ourselves a shootout on tap here.
That one falls.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make 5 in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
And that's the kind of lead pass we've come to expect from him.
Minnesota's gone 1-of-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Can't hit from in close. Here's Money, and he dunks it down.
Oh, Kevin, not a Petty, not a Manny, but a facial.
Oh, a bounce to the ounce, Greg? Yeah, showing off the bunnies.
He's a highlight reel always on the launch pad.
Ooh, just powered it down with both hands. You know he's not going to mess that one up.
Oh, no, not this fella. He is a superb finisher.
Yeah, near the hoop, he's an absolute monster.
Can't nail the jumper. Back to the action after this word. Welcome back, everyone, to the second quarter of play here on Noche Latina. Vámonos. And what do you guys think about Minnesota here in this one?
Well, you can see these guys are unafraid to take chances defensively.
Well, you know, the defense, guys, is just disruptive, active, and energetic, and you can't afford to be loose with the ball against these guys.
On the court for Minnesota, you've got Hachimura. Charge is out there with Hayes. Then it's Kendrick Nunn. And it's Noel in at the two spot.
And Hachimura's given name, Rui, means fortress in Japanese. And that's what he looks like out there. He's worked hard in the weight room, sports a solid frame with a terrific core and that great lower body strength.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Walker's checked in. And the foul on the monster. That's his first foul. Left side, Sharich. Here's Hayes. The pass to Hachimura.
And how about the read on that play right there? Great sense of exactly when that ball was coming from the outside. That's a stomach punch, guys. Mm. Turn it over and give him a free run to the bucket.
Oh, you're so right. No question who has the momentum now.
You know, those kinds of plays can be difference makers, game changers, momentum shifters, especially in a close contest where one or two possessions can impact the outcome.
And you combine Hachimura's power with that 7'2 wingspan, Greg. He's physically built to succeed in a positionless NBA.
And add to that, Kevin, he's got solid athleticism along with a versatile skill set. Hachimura still needs to work on creating off the dribble, shooting the jump shot with consistency, but with his work ethic, there's a good chance he turns those into strength.
But they get it back. They double-team Walker. Shot clock at 6. From downtown, it's hauled in by Los Angeles.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
Leonard kicks to Tyler. Back to Leonard. And it's Leonard with the jam.
Oh, and he went for the two-hander on the slam using some muscle.
Some urgency from him there, sure.
I get the feeling, guys, that he may be sensing that this is a critical time in this game.
Bagley finds Bamba. And here's Walker. The Timberwolves again can't hit.
And they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
Terrific accuracy on that pass. That's how you lead your teammate.
So the Timberwolves called their first timeout. When you look at the balance of power between players and teams, Greg, does it feel like the players now have more say, more control than they used to?
No doubt. We're seeing more players demand trades, sign shorter contracts with opt-outs. And the irony of that is, in my era, our best players were fearful for the length of their contracts or the life expectancy of their careers, believe it or not. And these guys today, they understand their value. They know what they bring to the table, and they are utilizing that to the max.
And is that good, Greg, for the game?
I think so. I do think most guys want to win, and they understand that their legacies are going to be defined about whether or not they do.
And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have. Staying aggressive and playing under control. And creating a little separation here, gaining some confidence.
Yeah, you get the sense that they're going to start stretching this lead out a little bit.
They could use a bucket. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. The Monster's got his 5th rebound right now in the game.
And offensively, he has been a liability more than he's helped this quarter.
Los Angeles. Dallas shooting their sixth and seventh free throw attempts tonight.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
Yeah, guys, they can feel very good about themselves when you bring up those statistics. Impressive numbers.
And Los Angeles with some changes. Money's checked in for Wilson. And Rain Man subbed in for Leonard.
No matter what looks they get, they just can't convert to stop this run.
And, you know, they've got to be careful because this is when the team concept breaks down and guys start playing hero ball.
Shoots from the elbow, falls through. He's now made 2 of 4.
And with that one, it ends an 11-0 run by Los Angeles.
Passes it to the monster. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. And Los Angeles leads by 7.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Knocks it loose. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Walker. And the voting for the dunk contest is just about over. So let's bring up the leading contenders for you. Boy, with the players on this list, you know this year's contest is going to be a fun one.
It is. And with their places in the contest almost wrapped up, I'm sure these guys are working on their moves already.
Take a look at Miracle Man. Some might say he's a long shot at this point, but you never know.
Hey, stranger things have happened, and we'll just have to wait and see.
And we're getting closer and closer to having our contestants determined. So be sure to stay tuned as we'll be bringing you updates very, very soon.
And partner, if we had the contest today, I'd be happy with the group we have right now.
Hachimura, he's checked in for Bamba. Thunder passes to Money. To the middle. It's a nice passing here by Los Angeles. Pass to Tyler.
Another foul would give him 3 before the half. Something to keep an eye on, guys.
Sharch has checked in for the Timberwolves. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up. Let's see the stat sheet here for him.
And it's a nice month he's having. Something's got him motivated. He's become a much bigger contributor offensively. He's settled into the kind of groove that every player wants to get in. And didn't have a single free throw in that first quarter, but he started. To play with a little bit more of an edge to his game here in the second.
And the Timberwolves call timing.
And they're picking up a lot of fouls already in the penalty. Not a good sign. They need to focus on moving their feet and maintaining a good defensive position.
ABC's checked in for Los Angeles. Here's Walker, and he uses the glass on the layup. Walker's got 6 points.
Boy, this little fella, Kemba Walker, is a treat to watch, especially when he takes it all the way to the cup. He's got explosive speed and finishes with ease on the drive.
And this offense is in a perfect rhythm, and you can see how they're finishing their play.
Boy, this is borderline ridiculous. I mean, every single attempt finding the bottom of the bucket.
Takes a 3. That one doesn't go.
Even with every shot clanging off the rim, he seems determined to keep hoisting up these 3. It might be time to get inside of that arc.
And while we can, let's have a look at the 2K leaderboard to find out who have been the most efficient scorers in the NBA this month. Take a look at Miracle Man, leading the league in field goal percentage. He always gets good looks. And, of course, Cowboy. He also shoots the ball so well. One of the best.
Both of these guys have been shooting with tremendous efficiency as the month has gone on. I don't know who's going to outdo who. And he just dangles from the bucket after sending that one through.
And you can see which team has the swagger right now.
Well, you know what? You don't want to do too much to get an opponent riled up. You got to be mindful of that.
Bagley with a wide open look. No good on the 3.
Yeah, and a dangerous trend here as they're starting to live and die with outside jumpers.
Really good point. I mean, you want to keep that balance, and attacking inside creates space for shooters, and having shooters creates opportunities inside. So it works hand in glove.
And pushing it up, here's Los Angeles. Here's ABC. Lays it up and banks it in. And Los Angeles leads by 17.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Almost no holes in their performance tonight. They've been tremendous.
6 seconds left. To play here in the half, and he commits the intentional foul.
Really no idea why you're fouling in a situation like that. You know, maybe there's some bad blood between those two.
Yeah, but that's no excuse for that kind of foul. I mean, that might be an explanation for it, but certainly doesn't justify it. And even then, it's a...
Oh my goodness! That was special!
Ooh, rising and punching it on the young fella. You know he loves having that much of a height advantage. Best chance to get yourself.
And so it's Los Angeles, out in front by 17 points at the end.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Greetings to each and every...
And guys, for Los Angeles, Kenny, what was your impression?
Well, they built this lead in large part because of the sharpshooters off the bench. The subs played a superb game.
And that does it for our...
And after... A very lopsided first half. We'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. Timberwolves trail by 17. Our second half of basketball and presented by Gatorade. Let's see who's all fueled up and on the floor to start the third. Taking a look at Los Angeles. We've got the professor. ABC is out there with money. And it's Rain Man. And it's Thunder in at the one. Pass to Bagley. Here's Noel. He kicks it to Walker. Shot clock at 5.
Boy, the heart of Walker, that competitive spirit, he's never afraid to go inside, and he's got a lot of different ways he can score in there.
Taking matters into his own hands.
Yeah, we didn't expect to see that kind of finish.
And you know, guys, when your point guard is making explosive plays at the rim, I really do think it sets the tone for the rest of the team.
Here's Bagley. And he overshot that one, missing.
That's a very low percentage shot. Not good basketball at all. One he probably should have passed on.
Changing ends quickly, getting the advantage in numbers and finishing. They've been doing it all night long.
You know, they've been the more up-tempo team, clearly. It's helped them gain the advantage in this one.
From deep, Walker. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. The professor's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And what I like about it, it's been a physical brand of basketball. It's had a little sandpaper element to it. Gritty and rough, but that's how you win games.
And that one is stuffed right through.
Boy, you have to be impressed with the offensive production. They have got it firing on all cylinders.
And, you know, the lead just keeps growing. I mean, this game. Is not going to get out of their grip. They're going to keep pulling away.
And it's a completely new group for Los Angeles. Here's Noel. He's covered by Leonard. Back to Walker. To halt the run. That's tipped, but he gets it back. Here's Bay. and it's wide right. It's off the rim.
Right thing there to stay that tight on him and really try to keep him out of his comfort zone. Hey, whatever adjustments they made at halftime, they are working to perfection.
You know, they came out of the locker room, revved up the gas pedal,
and haven't
slowed down yet.
Minnesota calls timeout.
Guarded.
Well, it's been an express lane to the rim. Coach can't be happy about that.
And, you know, I think he's going to tell them simply, we have to show more fight on the interior. That's the top priority right now.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Nunn's checked in. Noel passes to Bagley. To the left side wing. Here's Bay. He has five. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. The Monster's got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one.
You know what? He's just stone cold right now. Really not sure if he's their best option offensively as they try to get back in this game.
For Los Angeles, they have gone 6 of 9 at the line. First free throw is good. Hayes is checked in for Mohamed Bamba. And good on the second, so he makes them both. Here's Noel. 8 points for him. Now the pass to Bay to stop the drought. And it's off the back rim. No good for Los Angeles. They've gotten every shot to drop since halftime. They're 5 for 5 from the floor. For Los Angeles, they have shot the ball pretty well from the line, going 8 of 11.
Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Hachimura is checked in for Minnesota. And that's good as he hits both of his shots.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
100% since halftime? Come on now. I'm not sure this lead's going away anytime soon with that kind of marksmanship.
He can't get it to go. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. The Wizards on the road to face them after this game. And that's the third of four straight played at home. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. So it's Minnesota now. Minnesota's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. And Cowboy is going to pick up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. And the Timberwolves making a change here. Charge is checked in. Los Angeles calls timeout. Second half here. We're just over 3.5 minutes into it. Here's Nunn. Another miss by Minnesota. And here's Los Angeles. Right now on a 14-0 run.
And this offense is in a perfect rhythm. And you can see how they're finishing their plays.
Boy, this is borderline ridiculous. I mean, every single attempt finding the bottom of the bucket.
And it's sent back by Leonard.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Yeah, rebounding has been a big key in this one. They've asserted their will and have taken control on the glass.
Guys, they're looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Noel, it's hauled in by Los Angeles. 1:35 left here in the third quarter.
And the definition of teamwork right there on that alley-oop.
And, Greg, what about the finish? Bringing it down with some thunder. Yeah.
I'll tell you what, I think the pass was even better. I mean, that was room service delivery at its finest.
Hachimura kicks to Hayes. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Yeah, easy call.
Yeah, you could hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
And a breakdown here, guys. The hustle stats for Los Angeles.
We've seen them make the extra effort from a defensive standpoint, closing out airspace and sending shots back.
They haven't wasted time getting the ball up the court tonight either, and it's resulted in a lot of fast break points.
Butler, he's checked in for Minnesota. Passes to Hayes. knocked away. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. Walker's checked in for Butler. Walker against Leonard. Three-pointer. Walker's shot is off.
You know, he's just not taking good shots, not taking smart shots, forcing up a lot of low-percentage junk there.
And this is how you want to come out of the half. Prolific and efficient.
Boy, I like the disposition and attitude since halftime. They're patiently looking for good shots.
Now, here's Nunn. Taking a look at his numbers, he averages about 7 points a game.
And how's that for a move? The killer crossover. It's a thing of beauty.
Now off the inbound, and he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
Not surprised at all. He's shooting it well and scoring points in bunches.
That's a two-pointer from Walker, and good, and it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down.
You know what? Sometimes something good can come out of a bad possession.
Miracle man, the pass to...
My goodness.
And guys, that's not as easy as he made it look. You've got to have some skills to pull that off.
Well, he's got plenty of those, yes. That's for sure.
Yes, indeed. Let's just call him Ladder Climber.
That one falls, so he hits both of them. Here's Miracle Man. He's got 20. Rejected by Walker. 1 second left.
Oh, what a shot!
Oh, he brought the rain from deep. You can see why Walker's participated in the three-point contest. I mean, he's an ideal participant. He's a volume deep ball shooter.
And at the end of the third quarter, a huge... And let's go back to a terrific pass that we're calling tonight our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter form.
Served him up a tasty room service dime right there, boy.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today. As we get going in quarter number four. And a look at the five for the Timberwolves to start the fourth. We've got Kendrick Nunn. Mohamed Bamba is out there with Hachimura. Then there's Landry Shamet. And it's Lucas in at the two. And the kid picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Bamba dishes to Lucas. Nunn against Leonard.
Much better job of just taking care of the basketball, really putting the onus on the defense. Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Purposeful passing it is, partner. Their last 10 points have all come off assists.
And they're able to recover. Guys, some great passing from them.
Yeah, everybody's touching it, and you're starting to see the assists pile up because the rhythm is on display offensively.
Okay, two hands for safety. That's what they say, right?
That's right. He was ultra safe with that dunk, no question.
And he should be. I mean, remove all doubt. Get it down hard and simple.
Pass to Hachimura. Stolen by Wilson. And here comes Leonard leading the fast break. Oh, and the jam by Leonard.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
What? You mean the throwdown at the end? I'll tell you what, fellas. I mean, the highlight shows are going to pain them even more.
A little over a minute and a half of the fourth quarter gone now. The Timberwolves again can't hit. Here's Los Angeles now. They've got an 8-0 run.
Oh, how about using the rim to get some true hang time?
You know, he just wanted to make sure the landing was softer than the takeoff.
Yeah, right. I don't know how much weight that carries.
Now, here's Bamba, guarded closer. Hachimura kicks to Bamba. Pass to Nunn. The Timberwolves again can't hit.
And I think that one could have easily have fallen for him.
Miracle Man, the pass to Leonard. 6 for 6, he's yet to miss from the field.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint and powering it home. He ends a 12-0 run by Los Angeles.
Los Angeles calls timeout. Break and pick. What are the times when you played as an NBA player with a lot more contact, a lot was let go on the floor, to what we're seeing now. And there seem to be a lot of whistles, a lot of stoppage of play.
I mean, there's no doubt about it. You know, you got to allow players to defend. And if they're in a legal guarding position, let them do their job. Eliminate the cheap ones. Part of the issue, though, partner, is now so much of the game is played on an island, right?
Yep.
You don't have the crowds that you typically would see guys in back in our era. There's more space. The court, in that sense, is bigger. You're out there kind of on your own, man. And these guys are crafty at drawing fouls.
It's never been harder for a defender. And Bagley able to finish.
And the dogged attitude of Bagley. When shots go up, he wants to be the first to pounce on misses.
And that one drops for him.
Nice pass there to set that basket up.
The Timberwolves have gone 3 of 8 here in the fourth quarter. Here's Shamet. Not going to go that time. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Here's Miracle Man. Here's Tyler. Another shot. Bagley with the block.
And a skilled shot blocker to boot. Love how Bagley uses that height and reach to stifle shooter.
Here's Jerome. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. The Professor's got 6 rebounds here tonight. And Bamba pulls it down. Bamba's got 8 rebounds in this game. Tyler passes to the Professor. And he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for 2. Marvin Bagley picks one up.
He had a defender all over.
He got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
Greg, you know, we're seeing play. Here's take control of their free agent destiny. Do players get a bad rap for that and switching teams?
I don't know if you get a bad rap, but you're going to catch the wrath of the fan base. You think of Paul George in Indy or KD in OKC, and fans, they're going to feel guilty. There's no doubt about it. They're going to feel scorned.
Yeah. That free throw missing. And he sinks the second.
Boy, he'd sure like to have that miss back. Hard to chip away at a lead when you're leaving freebies at the line.
And the powerful one-handed slam.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish.
Part of what makes him unique, guys, that combination. Power and polish.
And Los Angeles will go for a different look here. Jonas Valanciunas, he's checked in for Tyler. Robertson comes in for money. Thunder's checked in for Leonard. And Anthony subbed in for Miracle Man. And now, let's take a look at the New Balance player of the game, Miracle Man.
And what an amazing ball game we've seen from him. It's been a one-man show worth the price of admission all by itself. There wasn't anything he couldn't do on that court tonight.
What a connection he has to these fans. They love him here. And the more he has games like this, the deeper that connection gets.
Oh, why, dunk you very much.
He can really fly, and you combine that, Greg, with some nice penetration, too, and you've got 2 points.
A lot of bounceability there, guys. I mean, well above the rim. That's what makes him dangerous.
And with the frequency of 3-point shots skyrocketing, Greg, does the drastic change concern you? And should something be done to lessen the dependence these teams have on three?
It's crazy. I mean, we're starting to see teams take more threes than twos. You know, some have said maybe limit fouls on three-pointers to only 2 free throws. That might eliminate some of the flopping on those long-range attempts, but I really feel like this is the evolution of the game, and that three is going to be vital.
Here's Miracle Man, and he jams it with authority.
That's a textbook example of how to move the ball. Boy, you gotta love that action.
And so they foul intentionally. And the first one drops. No good on the second free throw. This could get even more out of hand if they continue to put up points.
Wow, Kevin, what a performance we are seeing. Well, guys, this was never really a contest, just a total obliteration, if you will. And you can safely say mission accomplished now for Los Angeles.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought, an all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that. And man, they just pretty much blew them right out of the water. A clinic was put on display here today.
And the strong effort here will convert into what will be their 50th win on the season.
And once they polish off this win, they'll be one more victory away from sweeping the season series.
And this isn't one of those mini series either. I mean, this is a 4-gamer. As hard as it is to beat a team 3 times in a row, it's even harder to do it 4 straight.
And we watched one guy all night long, guys, and look at the stats just confirms what a dominant game he had. What a night tonight it was for Miracle Man.
Every time he shot it, it seemed like it was going to drop in. And if it didn't, everyone was surprised.
Good.
And with the lead, I like the strategy here. Continue to get the ball to guys who can do something with it.
If it's working, keep working it. That's what I say. Keep the pressure on them.
Really no idea why you're fouling in a situation like that. You know, maybe there's some bad blood between those two.
Yeah, but that's no excuse for that kind of foul. I mean, that might be an explanation for it, but certainly doesn't justify it. And even then, it's just not a good play.
And how about that? What a sensational finish.
Hey, you got to be able to get some hang time to do that one.
Yeah, to glide in and reverse it home like that, so sweet.
He makes 1 of 2 that time. They've been a little too casual with the ball out there.
Yeah, but you can't force that square peg into the round hole. Oftentimes, you just got to make that first simple pass and get a rhythm from that.
Puts it up from 12. Here's Rain Man. Nice work on the board. It's paying off with the basket.
And you can sense that these fans, these players, they are ready to celebrate.
And I think they can start that celebration right now. I mean, what a terrific team victory.
And he makes the first. Both good from the line that time. And here's Los Angeles. Here's Miracle Man, Jerome with the rebound. Here's Šarić. The Timberwolves, again, can't hit. They are enjoying the commanding lead.
And it really gives them the opportunity to give their starters a rest. Always critical when you get ready for that home stretch.
That's serving it up on the platter there. What a nice pass. A high percentage look was the result.
And he knocks down the first one. Both shots good from the stripe. And here is Los Angeles now. Here's Miracle Man. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
Saw the opportunity to put this away and did not turn it down.
And, you know, this run shows what kind of attitude this team has. I mean, the win is there. Go get it.
And he's good on the second. And here's Los Angeles. Goes up off the inbound.
Oh. Yes, sir. Come on, bring it.
And how about just floating to the rim on that slam?
Boy, when he gets up, I mean, he gets up.
Yes, he does. That's what we call yeelium. Yeast rising and helium floating.
He's perfect from the line this time.
Let's go.
15 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
And guys, it doesn't matter who you're rooting for. You've got to appreciate a reverse jam like that.
Greg, those kinds of dunks are how reputations are built.
Yes.
Well, his reputation is already pretty good. I think he just enhanced it right there.
The first one falls. He hits both from the stripe. Here's Miracle Man, defended by Butler. Miracle Man, banked in off the glass. Miracle Man's got 44.
But when you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
You know, he should be getting extra. Attention from the defense, not less.
Yeah, the good news, though, is they've already got the win wrapped up. He might as well sit back and enjoy this one.
He hits the second from the line. 6 seconds left to play in the final quarter.
Yet another bucket in close. That's how he's earning his points today.
And now we've got the intentional foul.
Number one.
First free throw is good. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. Here's Miracle Man. So it's Los Angeles winning this one easily. It was a tale of two teams tonight. One that was in total control, operating flawlessly, and the other just searching for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here.